大家好，欢迎回到我的频道，我的名字叫做 D，我希望你们一切都好。咱们转眼间就来到了12月份，今年的最后一个月了。那么我也希望咱们都能够加把油，把它给挺过去。因为毕竟对于绝大多数人来说，今年都是充满了挑战的一年，很多人都承受了来自方方面面的压力还有困难，我自己也不例外。我是今年受到了很多来自生活给我上的课，也因此呢产生了很多思考，以及对我自己的一种反思。其实从一个不同的角度来说，你生活中遇到的困难和挑战越多，你能够从中获得经验的机会也就越多，从中呢实现个人成长的机会也就越多。关键看你怎么去看待和把握这些困难以及挑战了。那我就想呢，跟大家分享以一种讲故事的形式分享一下我自己的一些思考吧。那么，好，咱们就是首先回到我小学的时候，我以前呢是一个非常愤青的小孩，我特别脾气不好，再加上我又是田径队的，所以脾气也比较火爆，然后对于世界的看法也都是非黑即白的，爱憎分明。然后我当时呢，隔壁班有一个女孩，长得也挺漂亮的，然后家境也不错，但是她班里面有一些跟我玩的人告诉我，她特别爱炫富。于是我就变得非常的讨厌他，然后呢，我对于他就是总想着要去教训他，因为他，我在我的脑海中，他给我们营造了这样一种攀比的这种氛围，这种不良的氛围是非常不好的，然后我需要给他上一堂课。然后我当时就因为是田径队的，有一些人际关系，我就利用我这些人际网去孤立他，然后有这样的倾向，在楼道里面跟他就是面对面，即使我跟他其实个人交往并没有什么交往，跟他不熟，我不知道他是怎么样的一个人，我只是听说他喜欢跟别人炫耀他家里有钱和他有很多很好小东西，然后他可以给别人。然后呢，我在楼道里面甚至去绊他，故意找他给他找茬儿。然后呢，我当时也是承受了这件事情的后果。他的家人找到了学校里面，然后学校也跟我找了我的家长和我去进行一些教育，思想教育。我也后期呢跟他道了歉，然后表了态，公开道了歉。我当时其实道歉的时候，心里还是有一点点小的愤愤不平的。我觉得凭什么我在替天行道，我在惩罚一个爱炫富的人，为什么你们要教育我？我觉得我没有错。但后来，其实随着生活的阅历增加，然后包括我家境的这个改善，不断的改善，然后我也体验了一把，就是成为了别人眼中钉的那种经历，包括就是，当然高中啊，来自这个班主任的这种霸凌，然后呢，我体验到了，就是说，一个无辜的人。就因为别人对于你的一些就是所谓他们那方面的一些臆想、一些看法，而强加给你这种罪行去惩罚你，就因为这些莫须有的罪名，他们自己脑海中这个捏造了一些罪名，然后我体验到了这个滋味，确实是不好受。然后呢，我也想就是就此真的是跟那个女生再次道一个歉，是真心道一个歉。我觉得吧，其实，受到别人欺负去反击是一回事儿，然后呢，面对一个无辜的人，就因为一些嫉妒心，其实说白了，我小的时候对于那个女生的恨，那些厌恶，就是嫉妒心，就是因为我家境没有她家境好，然后呢，我觉得，然后她个子也比较高，也挺好看的一个女生，我其实当时对于自己的这种情绪是不理解的，我觉得她就是，我就是讨厌她，但实际上我不明白，其实那份讨厌。就是说白了，嫉妒心，嫉妒心，然后呢，我就把这种嫉妒心呢去发泄到了他身上，而他是无辜的，他本身对于我来说并没有造成任何的伤害，他没有去伤害别人，他没有伤害我，然而我呢去费尽周折去故意找他茬儿，去伤害他，那这个本身就是一种恶。我当时是被这样一种邪恶的东西所占据了我的这个思维，然后我可以说是被嫉妒所蒙蔽了双眼，被我自己的嫉妒蒙蔽了双眼，这个不能怪任何人。然后呢，我觉得，这也是我这个成长中的一个非常令我羞耻的一个回忆。我今天也想就是跟大家分享一下，然后我从中的看法反思呢，就是其实人真的是会变的，就是说我在小的时候那样的一个校园霸凌的角色，在现在看来是非常让我在我现在的自己不能够理解的。我为什么要去故意伤害别人呢？我为什么要去针对别人，而别人对我一点一点是？ 伤害都没有造成，我为什么要去反而给别人造成了心理创伤？那么我觉得呢，这个真的是因为你的这个人呢，是会根据他的生活经历以及地理位置的变化，还有周围交际圈的变化而思维进行不断被塑造的。所以说呢，人的成长真的不是一个二维的直线性成长，而是多维的那种曲线圆形的成长。很多时候呢，它是乱七八糟的，就是你会有很多的成长的不同的阶段，而你的这个成长的经历呢，这个俗点说，你的这个成长旅程和别人的所有人都是不一样的，每个人都是在他个人的成长这个旅程的不同的节点。所以这也是我现在呢，通过我这种对自我的反思还有思考呢，从而就是减少我现在的戾气。其实人的情感就是由人的这个对于事物的反应还是两层的，第一层就是直觉性反应，物理性反应，就是你看到一件事情之后对你直接的这种情感式的反应是没有经过任何理性辩证的，然后呢，这种更是非黑即白的一种反应。另外一种就是通过你二度思考进行逻辑论证之后更加理性的一种反应。那么我现在呢，就尽量的，因为我自己的大脑也在不断的就是在发展着，然后呢，我的这个prefrontal cortex 这个控制我理性思维的这个大脑也在不断的增强着，我在与此同时呢，也对于事情产生了更加这个深刻一些的看法。所以呢，我在通过对自我的经历反思之后，我再去看到别人哪怕是对我伤害的一种行为呢，我也能够就是不去怪他们。当然呢，他们永远不应该去伤害别人，因为故意伤害一个无辜的人就是一种邪恶的行为。但是呢，我对于他们在不同的节点，他们生活不同的节点，以及他们认知不同节点，有了更加明白的一些认识。然后呢，我也能够自己心态更加平和一些，不管经历了什么样的不好的事情。然后，这个想跟大家，也是想跟大家分享一下。如果你有什么类似的这种人生经历呢，或者思考，也欢迎在我评论区帮我进行补充，我们可以进行一些讨论。也这个感谢您能够收看我的节目，收看到这里，我们下期接着见，拜拜。Hi, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. My name is Dee. I have gotten out of a Okay, so this year has been a lot, right? Life has taught me so many lessons and humbled me so much that I had a lot of thinkings and self-introspection done. And then I think about what I have been through for the past year, and then I just kind of want to share what I came up with you guys in the form of a little story, my personal story. So back when I was in elementary school, way back, more than 10 years ago, I was a pretty hot-headed kid. I had a very strong sense of righteousness, and my world was basically just a black and white, pretty binary. I was a cynical kid that just wanted to, you know, do justice. I mean, it could be good, but then it could also be bad. Unfortunately, there was a girl that was in the class right next to mine. And she was pretty tall, and she was from a well-to-do family, and then she was fine. But then these two friends that I was hanging out with at the time told me that she was actually a bad person, that she always loved to flex her wealth, bragging about how rich her family was, and that she just told everyone that she was pretty. And hearing that made me just really irritated, and I was angry. I just became resentful toward this girl, even though I didn't even knew her in person. And the story, when I started to use my connections from this track team that I was in at the time, I was an athlete in this track team, and then I started to use my connection to isolate her, basically. Then I would purposely pick on her, making her life a little bit harder. whenever, like whenever we would encounter each other in the hallway, in the corridors, I would trip her and just kind of making things more difficult for her. And I didn't realize how bad it was, even though I paid for my price for the consequences. I mean, her parents called in the school, and then the school contacted my family and then me, educating that it wasn't right. And then I apologized to her, even though in the end, publicly, deep down inside, I wasn't really satisfied with this result, because I knew I didn't deserve this. I was just trying to do justice, and I didn't feel like I was the one that's supposed to be blamed. But either way, fast forward, after I entered middle school, high school, and college, now grad school, my family started to getting better. I mean, not really well, but better in the financial situation. And also, I've come to make friends with people from all kinds of classes, you know, like all kinds of background. And then I also started to realize that it wasn't right for me to just accuse of someone for being sinful, for just being from a better family. And also, she wasn't kind of being mean to me. I mean, frankly, she didn't even know me at the time. Also, I personally have been through experiences where I was bullied, even though in the elementary school, in that particular case, I myself was the bully. And after I became the target of the attack, of the bullying, I started to realize that it wasn't right for a person to just come up with this imaginary character based on the rumors about this innocent person that they didn't even know, and then started to attack that person based on these things that might not necessarily be true. And it's one thing to fight against the bully for yourself, stand up for yourself. It's another thing to go out of your way to create troubles for someone that didn't even mess with you. So the moral of the story, people do change, and over the years, with the changing life circumstances, the circles of friends that you hang out with, people's ideologies and their mindset, their mentality does change as well. And in order to maybe be less angry, in order to be less angry at this world, you can start to look into your life story and then reflect on that. Which stage of life you're at, and what kind of stage of life the people that you hold resentment toward are at, and why you're resentful for them. Was it just because you were jealous? Clearly, I was really mean to that one girl because of jealousy, because her family was doing better than mine, and then I didn't like that. But as a child, I didn't understand my emotion, this feeling that I had, this jealousy that I had. I just thought that was because she wasn't a bad person. She wasn't a good person, and that's why I didn't like her. All right, so for now, after I have been through some bad things and then people were mean to me, I switched positions and then tried to, you know, think about what they have been through in life and what made them angry at me. And I realized that it was that they were going through something in their life that made them angry, and they didn't even understand their own emotions. That's why they took it off on me, because it was an easy way out. All right, so what I want to say is everyone has been through a very immature stage, and that's okay. What matters is that later in life, after you have been through more things to help you shape a, I would say, deeper way of thinking, after you've developed the required skills and techniques to think more carefully,
with more caution so that you can look at the world from a more profound perspective. Do remember to look back from time to time and then think through the bad things you have done and then own up to it. That's the only way to make peace with yourself. And I just want to say I have to apologize again to that girl, even though she probably will never see this video. And I want to genuinely say I am sorry. All right, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.